G'day guys, welcome to match 2, or maybe match 2, between Team North and European Gentlemen. Team North going Axis, Thompson is hungry, going on Assault Squad. Also Mr. Pringles going on Assault Squad with Japan, as per usual. And we've got NatNat with his Assault Squad as China. And on the other end, Room of the Beast as UK, or should we call it Great Britain, going to the right. And not too many sent to the center by the allies. Looks like they're storming the sides. Thompson storming the west. Pringles going to the center. So we are yet again in Mirage. A very building-orientated maps. And constant fight for this hill, as I have known. It's also known as Strat's Nightmare. Because I haven't won a tournament game on this in the last year and a half or so. And we have NatNat going to meet Pringles, the sandbag Thompson also coming in from the sides. Ooh, nice grenading. Many grenades at one point, at a time, using the spamming the F1 click. But not many hitting, though he does make them run and stop them from firing. Pringles is now moving in as well. NatNat going to return the favor. And cooked. Good enough. Takes out one guy. Chinese assault squads. And lots of singles, seems like they're getting outnumbered. Though here is Thompson with the PPD flank. NatNat getting flanked from the side. Thompson moving individually, very nicely spaced, but they'll need to run with the SMG. With a nicely cooked grenade by NatNat, takes out three. Wow, that is some superb grenading by Mr. NatNat. Boom, wow. Takes out Thompson's Thompson's full squad almost. Here he comes, Mr. Pringles with the Time 92, seen it a lot of times, hasn't tried it, didn't try it the last game, and now he's trying it once again, and I don't think they're ready for it. Pretty sure not, they are. Roman Beast has an AT rifle, but he's not in the right position. He's going to try flank. He's taken out five guys so far, so he needs to take out a squad to make it worse. He's got 150 MP. I think it's pretty much done its job, I think. It stopped the assault in its tracks. AT rifle has been spotted. Roman the Beast walking away. Sandbag line has been taken by Thompson. That was NatNat built sandbag line. Made in China, as everything is these days. That's a precursor to what the future is to come. NatNat. Conscripts. The spam is coming on. Whoa. That was an interesting grenade. There it is. Mr. Pringles with the assault squad flank. Takes out a few guys. Still quite a few conscripts in the center, and they will start capping the flag. NatNat, more conscripts. Also coming up with a half track. Decent buy. Its target was probably the Type 92, but if it doesn't get it, there's still lots of infantry to kill. So a very economical counter. A lot of Thompson's troops out in the open. These are just conscripts as well. And that also means they don't have 80 grenades on them. And that was a... Walk straight into NatNat's hands. And stopped in this tracks. Conscripts for running line of sight now. Oh! Thompson ready with the AT rifle. He's got him. Now Type 92 may come out to play. Looks like Pringles is going to return the favor to NatNat's conscripts. What? That 50 cal can be of... Oh, but never mind. Nice grenade from Thompson. That was... Didn't need to be perfectly cooked. As the conscripts of Calgary have a grenade that explodes on impact. AT rifle trying to hit Pringles. He hides behind the building. All conscripts coming in. Oh, that grenade didn't do too much. Another few guys. Oh, grenade again. Boom. Wow. Thompson actually returning the favor to NatNat. And I think that's pretty much even from the start game. Start game, NatNat went crazy. And now Thompson's going batshit crazy. Center's still going to European Gentlemen. 4-3, they take the lead. Now Roman the Beast is going to try and infest the area. He's going to push in further up. Pringles has some single infantry, nicely spaced, you can see on the minimap. It's pretty much, yeah, look at that. So he measured it perfectly. It's finish precision. Type 92. Ooh, let's see these guys get mowed down. Yep, you better hide. You better hide suicide infantry. Ooh. SAS soldier with the Piat. Oh no! He's dead. That was an SAS? Was that a... That was the Elite 80 infantry. That's quite an expensive loss, but Type 92 is flaming. We'll take down a few more before it The crew gets out. Yeah, there they go. Boom! This guy, wow, wasn't lucky enough to get the explosion, so it's a burn. Suffer the pain. I'm always scared to do close-ups, guys, because of the crashes. So I'm going to do some more. I'm being a bit more... Today, I feel more adventurous, so I'm going to do more close-ups. Oh, nasty. Crash or no crash, I don't give a shit. Thompson pushing up further. Look at that infestation all the way at the spawn. The spawn's right here, if I'm not mistaken. Look at the other side as well. Remnant Beast is infesting as well. Mr. Pringles does know it. And I think you'll fill the gaps quite quickly. Let's check out this one. This could be an interesting infestation to spawn. Conscripts coming up to just fill the gaps. This lone guy sticking out his head out the window. Bam, gets rifled. Boom! Oh, wow! That guy threw a grenade, hit the roof or something, and killed both of them inside. That was worth it. Interesting buy there from that, going the suicide inventory instead of the Panzer 1 or the M3AZ gun. You'll say tank aid. Pringles with 20mm covering the center. Now we'll stop them from coming in, the allies from coming in, but already that with a Sherman by. Pringles forced to duck away. Me on the cover. Misses. Collateral damage on one of Thompson's conscripts. Oh, what the hell was that? Something came running at the tank, but it blew up. The Sherman going to swing to the southern western point. Boom, boom, boom. Could it run down? Oh, the tankomata has been crushed, unfortunately. Never mind. It's at 80% efficiency still. Good enough. Veterancy gain on 20mm. Very safe position now. Sherman is trying to take out the guy in the building, and has another guy infestation. So slowing down the advance. Thompson doing well to just hide individual guys in the buildings. Definitely causing that net to force the marker on him and lose a bit of time. Chino already out from Pringles as well. Very good with the Chino. He knows the exact distance. He usually tries to fight at max range, as the Chino can penetrate the Sherman max. Sherman can't do the same, though Sherman does have the angle, and if you don't... Wow. That hit through the Type 92, I think, and hit the side? Hit right there, I think. Nasty. Nasty. Yeah, very good, very good. I've played Pringles many times, and that Chini, man, I can't deal with it. Such a great counter. Should work like the Panzer G, to be honest. I think it's just a bit smaller, so it's a bit harder to hit, maybe. Penetration should be about identical. So, I can't see why not. If you can do it with the Chino, I can't see why you can't do it with the Panzer G. But usually the German players like to go to the H for extra security. It is 20 MP cheaper though, the Chino. Though, doesn't have the MG. The additional MG. Flak now is confident. He's protected by the Chino big brother. And now will plonk himself down right in the center, which has full access to all roads, all these forks. He's in the perfect position. If the Flak was, let's say, a friendly guy, you could call him a marketplace right now. He's right in the center, can be accessed by any of the roads. Instead, it's now a killing machine, infantry killing machine, with all access to everything. So, what's going to happen now? Ooh, Snyder, 75mm, emplacement killer for the Chinese. Misses the first two shots. Usually a bit more accurate than this. It's very an accurate howitzer. But now Pringles will duck away behind the crates and the house. Really pressuring the spawn very hard. That's really stuck in there. Scared to move. Good cover, the home guard is as well. Home guard MG's in the center. He's gonna cut off the center from this way. I really like the positioning right now. So they're coming straight down from the southern west and gonna push out to the flanks here. It's gonna prevent them from coming to the center, or they can get hurt coming in. But Run of the Beast does get the Grenadier squad over here. And can still come into the center that way. The 20mm has moved. Just away from the Snyder. Snyder is still stuck in his that same position. Not being effective. And now he's going to try play a defensive one. Perhaps knock down the wall and he can secure the center even more easier. Thompson with conscripts is on the outside. Also gone the two special points? Three special points, I think. No, it's a two special. Can't remember, sorry. 20mm with the HE shell. Sneaky guy, Anzac, in the building. Pringle's going to glitch him out. Grenade hits the tree and he's safe for now. Oh, that grenade, for some reason, didn't kill the Anzac. Because his... Oh, rifle does anyway. But Thompson coming in. Realm of the Beast preventing the cap with the Grenadiers. Thompson relocating his 20mm. Snyder, I think he's looking for a shot. HE shell misses. Gonna duck away to the buildings. A decent unit to have on this map. Oh, nasty business there. Knocks down a building and crushes some of Nat's troops. Snyder not having the best of shots in this game. Hasn't been able to counter what it should. And oh, wow. Actually gets hit by a stray shot, I think. I don't think Thompson even knew he was firing at the Snyder. Snyder's going to go around here to take a better shot at that SDK. Thompson still oblivious to the fact, I think. Oh, no, maybe. No, no, he is. Oh, it's coming out straight to it. Oh, he sees it. I think he's going to have a shot. No, he's going to go back. You might as well just go for it, I think. Oh, Nat. Boom! He does go for it. Takes out the Snyder. What a shot. Thompson just now is going to stay here with Rampage. Oh, but no, the AT rifle. Oh, puts it away. That's the downside, I guess. So weak. So weak. Even the AT rifle can take it out. That's devastating damage. It's not repairable. It's gone for good, unfortunately. As the 150mm has appeared for Mr. Pringles. Boom! Takes out the machine gunner from the Black Watch. Placed in an interesting position. It's not really covered from this road. Oh, I suppose it may be. There's a rock there. But a Snyder could be placed here and can shoot over. I think Nat might go for another one. That's probably his best bet at this stage. Center. Grenadiers have been doing a good job stopping the cap, but now it's going to Team North. Or it can come back in the points, 19-12. Team European Gentlemen, slightly. Chinu misses a shot on the crew AA. 20mm is falling back. Oh, what's that? I see something behind the lines. Ah, it's just a guy in the building. Thompson is a guy in the building, so he must have line of sight as well. Chinu tries to take a shot, knocks the building. Oh, he does knock the wall down. I think he can take a shot again. It's probably out of range. Mortar hits the building. Chinu takes another part of the building. Crusader A scurrying away to spawn. It's really the battle of spawn in this game. Yeah, that's pretty much it. It's a good place to hold, in my opinion, because it's very hard once the enemy gets up here for the Axis team. And if you're able to contain them in spawn, you can see what's coming. You can infest the buildings to make it hard to actually come up to the hill, and from there you can prevent the attack of center or force them to come from the other side. So both of them, well, the Axis, Team North, are really focusing on just pushing on that tower from the west and southern all the way to their spawn, and Team European Gentlemen content with just leaving the other side. Team North hasn't actually tried attacking it. I suppose though, as Axis, that's what you do. You don't really want to go for all fire flags, because the allies do get a bit more infantry at the start if they're playing the spam game. 20mm shooting at the window, famous for having snipers on there. Don't think there's any this time. More infestation. Thompson going in further into the building, going to the house right there. Very hard to reach out. It's so annoying in AS2. It's really hard to kill guys in buildings. You have to micro grenade, pretty much. So even though this guy won't shoot anything, perhaps he'll just force you to click a few buttons, waste 3 or 4 seconds of your time. And especially if you're in Australia playing in lag, it's pretty much wasting six seconds, double the time, because it takes ages to click a button. Just a bit of a whinge over here. Shitty internet. Chinu. Straight in the open. No counters yet. Still, they haven't really thought about countering it. Still not. Tulip is out from Roma. Be quite the standard emplacement counter. Going for that mortar, I'm guessing. No, he went for the 20 mil and does so in the first shot. Wonderful. Chinu. Boom. Shoots the house instead. Falling back straight into spawn. This right side is actually quite in danger as well. Thompson's got guys all the way here. Pushing up some more again. Spamming that infantry. Chinu. Just going to try to take out the tilt when it can. No, it's going to go for the mortar. Nat has got his own mortar. Interesting. That's not the... That's just a normal normal mortar. M1 type mortar. So it won't do as much damage as Pringles. Pringles could actually try counter mortar. Actually, it's really hard though, because it's right against the building. But the 150mm mortar shell will take out the building in one hit anyway, so two shots perhaps. Well, look at those buildings go down. That's going to be nothing left of Mirage by the end of the game. It's only 31-19. Team North in the lead. Being strong. Roma the Beast on move at will. He's got the move at will command for some reason. Mortar preventing any mass assault in the center. We've also got the guerrilla forces from Nat, the zero CP conscripts, one special point. And let's have a look at this. Oh wow. Nat bought his own 150mm mortar. That's right, China has its own. It did take a lot of the Japanese ones. That's bought by MP, not special points. The shot from the Chinu takes out the hit side shot. Crew injured. Can the Sherman respond in time for crew injured? No. Engine damage, crew damage, but maybe. Can it take a shot? Oh no, it doesn't. Hull damage before he can do anything. And there goes that Sherman. Two Shermans down. Pringles and his Chinu wins again. And I think it might have been even a turreted Chinu that did that. Nice. Yeah, don't mess with Pringles Chinu. Last 1v1 I had with him. It was three Shermans to his one Chinu. His one Chinu killed all three, even though I did win the 1v1 by luck. Well, some, but his Chinu just totally wrecked me. He just knows exactly where to hit. Boom. Thompson following up with some flaming action. So yeah, they've got their 150mm. The tulips decrewed the mortar. It's still repairable. And that's a pretty good combo, in fact. I quite like that buy. This mortar plus the tulip. I should buy that more often, actually. I didn't ever consider it, to be honest. That's a really good buy, as China. Ping in the center. Interesting that Nat and Roma have the same army composition as me and Hansi. I love China because I am skillless. I like the spam I can't control. So Hansi goes UK. Cheeto from Mr. Pringles. Even though he's got the Chinu out, interesting. Must be quite CP capped. These tanks cost around 20 CP, so that's 40 CP on tanks. I guess the mortar's been taken out of that CP equation. So only about 60 CP or less for infantry. And that's mortar is now doing so much damage. Cheeto is going to try return the favor. Flyers at the house, protecting the mortar. And second shot hits the sandbag, I think. No, it doesn't. Sandbag's still there. Nat is in control. See that Chinu go for another shot. Nope. Boom. The mortar's just firing on the Cheeto for some reason. Cheeto, another shot misses, but here is a tulip for a shot. Perhaps going for the Cheeto, or perhaps finishing off the mortar. It's going for the Cheeto. Mortar has been relocated by Pringles. So, looks like Japan, or the Axis forces, do have the tank domination, and the Allied forces have the artillery rocket domination, mortar plus the Tulip rocket. And infantry wise, that's going to secure them the infantry in the meantime. Though Pringles has his mortar back up, but was acceptable to another Tulip shot when it gets ready, so eventually, I'm guessing that'll be the case. Chito for another shot. Not having much luck on that sandbank. Thompson marking his way in, sneaks his guy into the ditch, and he's capping the bag. A few other guys there as well. Ends up being Mirage. Really ends up being a slugfest for some reason. It used to be, in 2 years ago, it used to be a map where you attack all flags and it was so, yeah, just so swingy on all sides, but these days, I don't know, it's just so naturally turns out to be the southern west and the center. This area, Axis struggling to hold on to this point and then trying to attack the spawn. Just totally changed. It's so funny that the meta has changed so much over 5 years. The highest level of play keeps changing. It's just never, ever, forever evolving into potential better gameplay. Nat gonna pick up his bazooka. The guy was felled. Oh, here it comes. Oh shit. Bazooka! Oh wow. How does Pringles do that? All the time. Oh no, Tulip gets the 150mm mortar. Axis now has lost their big guns in the artillery fight. But yeah, how does Pringles get these AP shots off? Seen him so many times kill 80 infantry with a huge tank shell. Yeah. Just very, very accurate and quite lucky, but it looks like he just got a track as well. Actually, mortar from Nat in direct control, gonna go for the Chito. Stop the repair, I'm guessing. Now, Axis without their artillery. Top scorers so far, MVP Chinu, then Nat's type 97, 150mm mortar is going to come back. Oh, sorry, take the lead shortly as the game goes on. Not being counted, but what is Pringles doing with the Chito so close up? Wow, another AP shell disintegrates an AT infantry. Another one? Don't tell me another one. Another one? What? Is Pringles crazy? And why is this tank guy so far up? He really wants to take out the Tulip. He really wants the Tulip. That's what he was doing. But I can't believe three AP shells. I guess it's close range, but wow, you gotta really flick that DC shot. It's a pretty hard direct control shot to hit. What the hell? That Firefly. What's a Firefly? It's not the Tulip's over here. It's gonna go for the Firefly. Firefly can't take it to Chito. And it can't take it out at max range, which is 140. 140 range, yep. Compared to the 130 of the Chinu. The Chito. And Chito can take out the Firefly 2 at max range at 130. But that finally gets his bazooka off. Chito now destroyed quite close to the front lines, meaning it can be repaired. It won't be repaired, I don't think. Maybe Thompson's gonna throw dynamite. No, he picked up the machine gun. They're like recycling in Sweden. Has the micro to pick up a tank MG off the and give it to a tank crew. Wow. I wouldn't do that. Tulip takes another hit on the 150mm. I think killed another 150mm mortar. If that's the case, Pringles has lost heaps, and the cheat Tulip has taken the leader. Taken the leader on the scoreboard. Taken over the leader. Now here's a 2-2 Nat coming in the center. Chi-ha coming out. Counter for that 2-2-2. Oh, nice shot. Takes out the 2-2-2, still repairable, and nearly actually ran towards the... No, hit the building. Imagine it ran over the wall, that would be funny. Crusader AA from Rome of the Beast venturing into the town. Might be able to flank that Chi-ha, perhaps, later on. Huge amount of conscripts from Thompson. Ah, this is from the Banzai, okay. Pringles Chi-ha from the Banzai. But here comes Roman with the Anzac. We'll take out one of the chihas from the Banzai. Pringles really likes to use those chihas very aggressively. Send them in a rush. Suicide mission. Mortar. Still going. 25 minutes in. 57-25. Team North have a very big lead. But now aren't looking too strong with what's on the field. Oh, sorry, I didn't even notice this. Veteran Tas from Thompson. This is a beast. This is indeed a big, big beast. H724. Like the Panther, but better armor. Bit more expensive. And veteran, which means it will fire faster and more accurately. See what impact it's going to make. It's playing very, very, very safe. Got a few buildings for cover. It's probably going to stay back till it finds a target. Chiha has been taken. Sorry, the Crusader AA has been taken out by the Chiha. How? Not sure. Oh, over here. There it is. Firefly. Takes him out. Taz going to try hunt the Firefly. And wow, that mortar took out a lot. Mortars. Now third place, taking out 65 infantry. Counted, yep. Knocking out Paras, or the Banzai Corps, to be honest, has been a waste. I think hasn't worked for Pringles in the last few games. Seems to work better in a 1v1. Oh, Chiha going for a cheeky shot. Firefly misses. Here's that cheap half of another one. I don't think he can penetrate, to be honest. It's been very, very cheeky. Taz trying to track it, perhaps. Taz still at the back. Thompson not supporting the Chiha. Firefly really wants to take it out. Pringles also really wants to take him out, but I don't think he can. This little pea shooter. Firefly, another miss. I think Pringles has just forgot. Who forgot about it? It's got a better thing to do. Looking somewhere else. Hellcat. Hellcat over here from Nat. Takes out the Toldy Eye over here. Oh, here comes a Taz. A Chiri from Pringles. This game has turned out to be a big bank, isn't it? A Chiri and a veteran Taz out. That's huge. But they're still lacking some infantry. Also lacking a bit of infantry killing power. On the other hand, the other side has very susceptible tanks to damage, but they can dish out a lot of damage, which is quite exciting. Very risky, but can still pull it off with these tanks to take out the tanks that the Axis have. But swarms of infantry. Look at that, United China. Swarms of infantry. Plus that mortar. So they've got the infantry battle down pat, and they've also got the mortars and infantry killing down pat, where the Axis have the tanks down pat. And yeah, I'd say the Allies are stronger because of that. Tanks don't win the game. It certainly don't, but in combination with other things they do, I think the Axis just needs some infantry killing, but perhaps they're just going to go tulip hunting. Chiri shot at nothing. Veteran Taz and Chiri, tank hunters in the center. Like brothers, but from a different mother. Oof. Pretty cool, huh? Not very often. This is actually the first time in probably my 800-something cast of a game that we've seen a veteran Taz and the Chiri in a game. Not even a tournament game, in a game. Side by side, but quite formidable. Let's just take away this UI. Let's have a look at this. Hellcat in the background, still playing safe. There's a sniper from Nat. Nothing much happening. They're both shooting HE shells, just trying to knock down buildings, I think, to open up the map. That's what they really need to do, maybe even get a demolition squad to just blow up all the buildings, and then these tanks will have free rein to shoot at the mortar, shoot at the tulip, and that's what they're doing. Pringles is just going to use AP shell instead, open up the field. 30 minutes in, turning out to be interesting. A very, very weird, but interesting dynamic between these two teams at the moment. The other team allies definitely holding strong with the amount of killing power for infantry. Knocking down the building so very slowly. Demolition squad, guys, I've added that in the game. It's pretty damn good. They've come with two dynamites, one satchel, each of them, and there's four of them. And they've got about, I think they've got 350 hit points or 300 hit points. So they can withstand hits before they throw it off, so. Be perfect. Boom, 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 boom. And if this game crashes now, I'm going to be so upset to wait 30 minutes. Just letting you know, guys, if this crashes, I am going to smash my hand against the table. Nothing drastic, just gonna, yeah, make a bit of noise. It's old man styles. Chiri. Taz going back for some reason. Why is he on move? Free moving, I don't know. That must be an accident. Thompson. Try to root out the guy inside. Lands it. And the one's there, mate. Paranoia. Talk about paranoia. He sneaks right in. That's gonna... Oh, actually, he was trying to shoot at the building, I think, but gets those other guys to it. The wasted shot, he takes out four infantry. That straight away comes in to take it back. Looks like Nat's gonna just leave his guys in the back. They don't cost CP, so he's just gonna send them one or two at a time to just play the center grenading. Wise choice, allowing his MP to bank while that's happening. Not wasting music, using another China. Needs a bit of patience to be able to do that. Definitely showing he has that in spades. Chiri, really not doing too much. Been knocking down buildings, but there's still a lot more to knock down. I'd really love to see the demolition squad. Please bring it out. Toldy Eye from Thompson with the 20mm. That's what they need. Oh, here he goes. The mortar has been exposed slightly. Perhaps the Chiri can take it. Nat venturing more of his guys into the center. Big slugfest. None of them risking... None of them obviously shouldn't charge. So always a one or two guys coming in to grenade to try to cap the center. Oh, Tulip's really not choosing the right targets at this stage. Hellcat just going to go for a risky one. What's it doing? It's running straight in there. It's had enough. He's going to try to take a 20mm. Interesting. Told he doesn't notice Thompson is not using it, but doesn't matter. Chiri takes the paper-thin armor of the Hellcat through the building. Wants to destroy it completely. Steel rip not anymore. It's flaming, so that means it's not going to be repairable. And the 20mm now can still support the center point. Though for some reason isn't firing. Oh, there's a little rock. Sorry, a wall. Blocking. Allows Nat to cap it. Now Thompson gonna send his conscripts. The Hungarian conscripts actually does very well in this center crater engagement, because the grenades land, destroy on impact. It'd be easy to micro the grenade to take out the guys hiding in the crater. Pringles coming in as well to support. 20mm. And it's going to rout him off, turning out to a World War I battle now. Battle of the Somme. So easy though, Nat has been relocating his mortar. And so difficult that Chiri is having a difficult time trying to knock down the buildings. It's taking forever. HE shots sometimes knock it down, sometimes don't. And we don't know the strength of these buildings. It's quite hard to tell. You can tell in the European style buildings, you just hit the roof and a couple times it'll fall down. But Mirage, these buildings are actually quite strong. Need that demolition squad. Please. Please, Thompson, is that demo? Oh, that's not demo. Home guard. How's he doing as a home guard? Oh, it's conscripts. Interesting, the Cheeto is repairable, so I think the Cheery can actually protect. Perhaps that 20 mil can come here, protect the Cheeto with the Cheery. Taz has been very inactive at the back with Thompson. Chinu from Pringles on the right, interesting. Perhaps Thompson's placing it so the Tulip won't kill it in one blow. Though it's a bit far, in my opinion. And now, Tulip finally aiming at Chiri, the target he should be aiming at. 62-49. They're holding on. Both teams looking to be strong. Both teams can still win it. I don't know who's going to win this day. Piat coming out from Roma. Oh. AT guys to take out the guys in the crater. 20 mil backing away for some reason. Ah, because of this. 4.7, Kanona. Decent choice, since the other team doesn't have any mortars. Funny to say it, especially when you're fighting Japan. The UK team has done very well to neutralize the enemy mortars. And sorry, my pop filter just fell down. Hell is... Oh, shots. Chiwi takes out the 4.7. Oh, no, it's still alive. Gun needs damage, however. Oh, no. I see this. Nat, 80 infantry. Young P. Oh, he notices it. He notices it. Can he do it? Yes, he does in time. Takes out Nat, the sneaky bugger. 65-49. Wow. Actually, this is probably the closest game I've seen in the tournament yet, and doesn't look like to be ending anytime soon. Though quite slow. Easy for the caster. Easy for the camera angles. I can just focus on one area. And this is where all the action is going to happen. Center. Bit by bit. Not many losses coming up because they're just little infantry coming in bit by bit. No one risking a big play as of yet. 108. 115 with the mortar. We're racking it up. Definitely racking the 80 grenade on the Chinu. And what was happening there? I don't know why. What was that Chinu doing all alone in this area? Perhaps he was just going for a YOLO charge on the Tulip, perhaps. That was definitely very risky. Tolly being very, very aggressive, coming straight to the center. 222 coming at the play as well. 150mm mortar coming. Take out infantry. Oh, it's going to walk into 222 for the slash shot. No, he's not. Thompson, oh, shot by the Chiri, takes it out, but also, I think, what took that out? I don't know. Oh, the Kananda. It's back up, the same one. It wasn't killed, and it's come back to bite the Chiri in the ass, but well, bring. And that next actually going to try track the Chiri, perhaps. Not going to finish it off. The Firefly finishes off the Toldy instead. Firefly's been very patient and inactive. Until that shot, staying on the north and east. But on the other hand, we've got the very in front of your face Chiri, entire game sitting here. And there he goes, the track. Nat got what he wanted, but now we'll lose the 47 mil, but now we'll enable maybe a flank. It's quite hard. Chiri has a very strong side armor, so I think there's no way of a flank. Unless you get that bazooka going, but whoa, Thompson. Oh, grenade does nothing, unfortunately. Some ammunition for the Tulip. Nat relocating again. Piat from Roma the Beast. 40 minutes in the game, 74-49. Axis ticking up ever so slowly. Very intricate silk woven garments for these conscripts. Well, here is an assault now. Finally, a different flag is being focused on. Nat coming in perhaps with this conscripts in there. I can see the Chinese. Whoa. Veteran Tas puts it away. Now Tas is good for something at least in this game. It's last line of defense. Pringles is moving his paratrooper squad to clean up of any survivors. And that is interesting to see that the conscripts just come out of that unscathed. Happens always, pretty much. If you take it a half track, sometimes all the guys just get knocked off, even though the half track explodes. It's interesting damage. Oh, what? How does Pringles do that? He's like got anti-infantry, anti-tank bullets. Anti-AT infantry. Well, not this time. Oh, it bounces. Oh, what? What? How does he get this? That's a Chiri too. Chiri's not that accurate either. And just one shot, AP shell, not a HE shell where you can hit anywhere and the explosion will just kill things in a certain radius. AP shell has to hit the guy directly and it does it all the time. Hacks. I suspect hacks. Reconnaissance leader from Brahma the Beast. Line of sight being blocked by that building though. He's gonna try spot these tanks. Excuse me. Piat from Brahma trying to take out the troops inside. You can see Nat Nat's MP has gone down to pretty much nothing. Though, as China, you can see, he's only got 42 CP spent, meaning the trickle tick up is 1.3 MP. Piat, oh, don't tell me it's a fire shot. No. What is he doing? Ah, oh, he's gonna finish up the Cheeto engine. There he goes, finally. These two tanks now being used very aggressively. Wow, what the hell was that inside? Very, very aggressively. I'm gonna try use their machine guns support. That's pretty much all they have at this stage. Mortar still alive. Wow, Veteran Tas takes that one guy as well. Okay. Is that a... no. 84 to 49. Axe is kind of winning the center engagement in terms of capping it. It's funny, huh? No one's really winning the game, but Axis have capped the center flag for the last 15 minutes. Ticked up to 85 to 49. Routing MG in an interesting position right in the crater. Very hard. Okay, not very hard to hit. What's with Team North and using giant AP shells to take out infantry? This is interesting. Very interesting. Type 97 mortar. How many kills has it got now? 116. Jesus. It's gotta be a record soon. I wonder what's the record in the tournament game. I wish there was stat takers and game analysis after the game stuff. So, unfortunately, it's a team of strat most tournaments. I can't do all of that. Godwin has been helping a lot organizing this tournament, and I have just been casting it. So thank you, Godwin, doing the hard work, forcing the players to turn up to their games, and playing or making the hard decisions. Not really hard. Doesn't matter if you make the wrong decisions in a tournament. They'll just have Nat screaming at you. Veteran Tas. Shooting at nothing. Oh, shot. Only takes out three, but... still capping the center now, Team North once again. Firefly has been really chicken. That's mortar. Racked up some more kills. And now coming to the center once again. This is total European play. Just... wow. That foray into the western and southern stopped, and Netnet doesn't want to try that again. Perhaps Axis should now try the northern east Because I think two of these heavy tanks in one location is a bit overkill. Why do you need the two of them in the same location? Maybe the Taz can come up from this way and lock everything down there. Oh! Oh! And that's what you get for staying so close. Oh no! Veteran Taz gets hit. Dies in one blow. The tulip, that's the tulip for you. One of those days will hit, but it's very casino. But when it hits a tank, it can... I've never seen it hit a Taz before. But usually if it goes for a heavy tank, it has to kill the engine to make it flame. It doesn't usually hit it and make it explode like it did the Taz. Unfortunate there. Big loss for Team North. 85 to 54. And 100 points in the lead kills. Tulip. Wow. Tulip, king of the hill. As these rocket type units, as the game goes on, the longer it goes, the more effective and more damage it will do over time. Chiwi takes up the Firefly. Runs in. Where was it? Right here. And it's down. Now the Tulip though, it was so evasive, still at the back. Ready to fire at the Chiwi once again. Though mind you, Veteran Taz did nothing except kill that half track for the last 20 minutes or more. So maybe not the biggest loss in the world. Just, I guess, a loss of potential opportunity and potential backup. So Chiwi, now that Chiwi dies, there's no backup. And now they don't have an option to attack the Northernese with another heavy tank. Ooh, there you go. First hit on the mortar, perhaps. Mortar has been decrewed. No, Roma tries to tow the mortar. You can't tow the 150mm mortar. They go straight in. Chiwi going for another shot, most likely. Fortunately, does not. Mortar now relocating. Being so evasive this game. So hard to kill. And now back into safety. Chiwi holding on center has been decapped. 85 to 56. It's really gonna decide the battle, I think. The tulip. Once the tulip takes out the Chiwi, they're screwed. Chiwi has been holding them in the game. Boom! Let's get under. Chiwi is actually up there in the kill count too. 70 infantry. Just been plonked in the center, uncountable. Doing good work. Tulip misses the shot, but here comes that bazooka. Angled well, but doesn't matter. Oh no. Repairable, but they can push. And Mortar can take out the guys repairing and then get the infantry up to get the dynamite and destroy the tank. You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking, why don't I just throw the dynamite out when I have buy a heavy tank? Because most likely, if it dies, the enemy will throw the dynamite at it to destroy it. And most likely, if it dies, it'll be dying in my territory where I can repair it. So, what is the point of having a dynamite on the tank? Nothing. So I might do that, just as a habit. Force a habit, because at that stage of the game, you have a bit of time to micro, you just have to just click a few buttons to drop the dynamite. Just one silly little thing that will improve my game 0.00001%. Just a funny weird thought I just had. Tulip for a shot at the Chiha. Takes out conscripts. That's a swamp of conscripts plus Roma's militia. Have taken the center from Team North. European gentlemen now ticking up. 57, 85, 50 minutes in. I just want to tell you guys, uploading a game of this size, it's about more than 10 gigs, and on Australian internet it will take me 2 days overnight. So I'm going to leave my computer overnight. and it's just, yeah, painful, to be honest. It's a bit of, if I only have USA internet, then I won't have to do that. The electricity definitely costs more than the ad revenue. The dollar. Conscripts coming in the center with the militiamen on the right. Cheery. So it goes. They're trying to finish up the cheery, that's what they should do. European gentlemen doing the right thing. Should have no problems now. Guy with the... Oh, it crashed. Alright guys, 15 minutes in, I'm not gonna sit and load the game. There's no fast forward feature in replay, so I would have to sit and wait 15 minutes, which I'm not doing. Sorry. Yeah, this is not worth it. Bloody crashes. So anyway, the game was won by European gentlemen in 1 hour, so 10 minutes after the fact. Yeah, so good game. I'm not sure if they're gonna replay the first game, and I think they should. Nat's currently away on a bit of a holiday in Italy, so waiting for him to come back to see what will happen to the decision. See you guys.